Hello friends, how are you? In this video we are going to have a look at a DSLR camera called Nikon D5100. So let's have a look at the price from the official Nikon India website. So you can see here the approximate the price is 31,000 with 1855 mm lens, which is this one, this little lens. So actually I got a deal, so I get this little and this bigger one lens together at low cost. So if you just buy the body, it will cost around 26,000. So you can see here there are so many features in this DSLR camera. So let's have a look at the other website to check out the price for comparison. So you can see that the Flipkart have a less cost or less price. They give it approximately 25,000 rupees, but it's sold out because this model is old model, and they have released a new model of this camera. But the cost of that camera is very high. So compared to that, this camera, if you can buy new camera of this model or second hand model, then as a beginner photographer it is useful for you. So you can see here they give a 2-year warranty, 10 days replacement policy. There are a lot of more specification they give. You can shoot at full HD 1080p. You can see here it's body only, so they don't give any lenses at this price, right? So there are so many features, it's a long list. You can connect it at USB 2.0, 3-inch display, TFT LCD, HDMI output, so you can connect this to the projector or device like that. The body of this camera is approximately 500 gram. So the problem with DSLR camera, this camera or any camera, because of the body weight as well as the lens weight, the total weight is very high. So it's very hard to shoot the videos by holding the camera because the weight of the camera is very high, so your hand get hurt because of that. So it's better you purchase a lightweight tripod and put it to any place where you want to shoot your video, right? So it's better to holding on the hand. So let's have a look at one more website, Snapdeal. So over here you can see this is already sold out because this model is closed. So only few websites are selling this thing. So over here it's 29,000 approximately. Maybe they are giving the lens. We need to check it out. Yes, I am right, they are giving 1855 mm lens. Over here you can see 1080p you can shoot, TFT, you can connect to the external microphone, which is also very important. Weight is same, 2-year warranty. Battery is LPE6N. So there are so many people had purchased this camera because actually this is a very low cost camera. Other DSLR cameras are very costly. So the problem with this camera is there are so many people are very interested these days to shoot 4K videos, so you can't shoot this 4K video using this camera. as well as this camera don't have Wi-Fi, so if you are going to an event or party or marriage, something like that, and always you have observed that lots of people ask the photo of them, means once you take photos of them, so it's hard to transfer the photos using this camera directly on the spot. There is one more disadvantage, that is you can only shoot or record video up to 30 minutes at one time. So it's not like that once you press the record button and it will keep recording until the memory is full. So it's not like that, you can shoot only 30 minute video. So this is the problem if you are going to 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour concert or event and you want to just press the record button and sit down until the memory is full or battery goes die. So it will not happen, you have to check at every 30 minute. The another thing is that means this is also one disadvantage of any DSLR camera, that if your battery goes die or about to die, you can't connect this camera to the phantom power or external power source. You need to take off the battery, shut down the camera and take off the battery and replace with charged battery, or you need to recharge your battery outside the camera. So your recording or photo shoot is stopped because of that. So because of that reason, you need to always keep extra battery. So you can see over here the cost of the batteries are very high, so approximately you need 2 to 3 batteries if you are full-time photographer or videographer. So you need to keep this thing in mind. Even you can't connect this with any power bank, it will not work. There are some solutions are given on YouTube that you directly power up the batteries, but I have never tried it. Means I need to manually make this thing, this kind of thing, existing means online it's any existing product is not available which help us to directly power up. There are some available, but it they are very costly, so I guess it's not worth right now. So batteries are also need to be considered. And one more thing is that you can shoot 1080p HD videos or photographs, so you always need extra memory cards, because 64 GB, 32 GB is nothing for HD video recording. It will easily full up in maybe 1 hour or 2 hour recording. So you can see the prices of the memory card. If you means total means you can calculate in this way, you can calculate total cost for your whole camera, your battery, your memory card, lenses, all the stuff. So you can see here the cost for 64 GB is approximately 3,000 rupees. So it's like that. And there are some specific battery charger are available, so you can recharge more than one battery at a time. So you also need to buy that thing, because with this camera only this charger is coming, so you can recharge only one battery in this charger. Okay, so let's connect, let's start this camera, put it down, all the stuff. You can easily change these lenses, but it will take time. It's not like that you just shoot one photo, change the lens, shoot another photo. It's not like that. let's load this thing on the camera. So you can see the benefit of this camera is that you can flip this screen, and if you want to, means if you are solo videographer or photographer, so you can means if you are traveling or making vlog, so you can see or observe yourself while recording the video. So this flip screen is very useful in that way. So one more thing, we can just check it out, the connections. So over here, as you can see, you can connect the external microphone over here. I have one microphone, so you can directly connect it here and record the audio. You can connect this to GPS device, you can connect it to the your TV, stuff like that, right? So it's very useful. So over here you can see one, this is the internal microphone, and here is the speaker. You can see some holes. So this is lens focus, autofocus and manual focus, which is also very useful feature. You can just change this setting and press the record button and start video recording. One more feature is auto exposure lock. So if you are shooting against the light source or shooting under under the shades or something like that, so at that time you need to focus on means you need to set your exposure and lock that exposure. So while shooting the video or photo, it will not change, the light of the video is not changed. So this thing is very useful in that way. So over here you can see manual setting, aperture priority, shutter priority, program mode, auto mode. You can shoot with effects, micro mode. So these are ready-made. I use this ready-made mode so many time when we don't have enough time to shoot the video or photo. So directly I use this thing. You can zoom in, zoom out using this button. So let's try to one more thing, you can connect external flashlight over here. Actually I didn't buy it, but I really like to buy, but overall cost as well as the weight of the camera is very much increased. You can directly you can open up the flashlight if you want to take this Poco flashlight. You can directly use it. You can set the timer and click here to start the timer. Actually I like timer functionality because while we need to shoot different jump shots like this, we need this self timer. So in this you can set the timer up to 20 seconds. So this is very good, so you can go backward and take your time to jump. So this is also good feature. So let's do one thing, we try to shoot one simple video. And check the audio quality using internal microphone, right? So let's press record button. You can see record button start blinking. So let's check out the audio quality. Om Bhurgo Swat Sahi Durvaranyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Namah Prachodayat. Okay, now we stop and we go and we play. Did you see? So you can directly hear from this thing. So one more disadvantage of DSLR camera, or maybe for this camera, that you can't monitor your audio while you are recording. So they don't give that kind of port in this camera, which is actually essential for video recorders, videographer we can say. So that is the disadvantage of this camera. So let us check some more feature into the menu. So you can change the settings. See, you can change the 1080p 30 frame per second, 24 frame per second, stuff like that. You can change the white balance, you can change ISO, you can set the timer, you can see it's up to 20 seconds. So with this camera you can do so many things. You can shoot hyperlapses, you can shoot startles, you can shoot I hope you know the bulb mode concept or night painting concept. You can shoot night painting with the bulb mode available in this camera. You can shoot this kind of startle as well as the night paintings like that. So means if you making YouTube videos and you want to make your YouTube video trailer, and you want to write down your company name, YouTube channel name using this light painting, you can do that using bulb mode available in this camera. So there are so many features in this camera. So I hope you can buy it new, or you can buy a second-hand camera. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks.